Hello world, I am Gavilan Steinman and this is onshouldersTV. In this episode, we'll be adding more sensors to our dogbot foot. Now we've already added our pressure sensors. But today we are going to add an accelerometer. This is a three-axis accelerometer, meaning it can measure acceleration in three dimensions. And we're also going to add an infrared proximity sensor. This is a digital infrared proximity sensor, meaning it can tell us when something is within 5 centimeters or not. It's a yes or no type of thing. It can't say that something is 3 centimeters away or 4 centimeters away. It can either say, yes, it's 5 centimeters away or closer, or it's not. So let's add these to our dogbot foot. All right, we have all three sensors installed. We have our force-sensitive resistor. We have our accelerometer, three-axis accelerometer, and our infrared proximity sensor. And we've wired all of these into an Arduino. So now let's plug our Arduino into the computer. Let me walk you through what we're looking at here. We are visualizing the sensor data from all of these sensors, and we're visualizing it with this pyramid. If we rotate this foot to the right, the pyramid moves right. If we rotate to the left, the pyramid moves left. If we rotate backward, backward, and forward, forward. Next, if we apply pressure to the foot, the pyramid squishes. And finally, if the foot is 5 millimeters away from the table, or more than 5 millimeters away, the pyramid is blue. If it's closer than 5 millimeters, the pyramid is red. Now there's one more thing I want to point out while we're here. Watch the Z axis, which is the blue line. When I hit the table very quickly, the Z axis spikes. I'm pointing this out because we are going to be able to use these sensors redundantly. And I think that's very exciting because that means we can compare the value we're getting from the pressure sensor or the force-sensitive resistor with the value that we're getting from the Z-axis acceleration. We'll be able to compare them and have redundancy built in. If I didn't cover something that you would like me to cover, let me know in the comments, and I'll see if I can cover that material. And if you like what you see, please subscribe. I will be including links to the sensors that I just added to the dogbot. So if you want more information like the specifications, down below. And I'll see you next time.